time. Daddy, we don't have a choice. Jean and I have lovely boys. Together, we are Jean and Daddy. David is my boyfriend. Jean and Daddy. Our fun will never end. Jean and Daddy. Daddy, we don't have a choice. Jean and I have a lovely voice. Together, I am Daddy Poe. I am Jean and the Hedgehog. We are Jean and Daddy.
Hey, Jean.
Little buddy, what are you doing? You're gonna get hurt.
Sorry, Jean. I was getting all trained up for a battle just like Sonic did and for the Olympics.
Fair enough. And speaking of the Olympics, shall we review my boyfriend's series?
You mean Mario and Sonic Prevented the Deadly Six? Oh, that series was awesome. I want to review that, sure.
In that case, let's get started. Don't forget to check out Mario & Sonic Revenge of the Deadly Six on my boyfriend McInerney76's channel, and please subscribe to him.
So the story begins in part one, where we see Zaz and Zadig talking to Mephiles the Dark.
They talk about hatching a plan by kidnapping Sonic during the events of the Olympic Games in Rio.
We'll get to that plan a little later. Meanwhile, at 76 Knot Hole Drive, which is the house of Sonic and Shonic,
everybody is getting ready for the Olympics. And Shonic shows Amy his new invention, the voice-activated smoothie maker.
Apparently, Styx has some more weird conspiracies. Meanwhile, with Sonic and Mario, they're watching some old Olympics clips.
Then they talk about that night Whistler at the 2010 Vancouver Olympic Games when they became friends.
It's also right around the same time as when Sonic teaches Mario how to whistle.
Then Sonic goes to Shonic's lab and Shonic shows Sonic his new invention, his Rubik's Cube.
I must say that Rubik's Cube has a lot of gadgets, like a laser, a stun gas, and all sorts of stuff.
Let's not forget when you solve all the sides of the Rubik's Cube and whistle the 4J mocking tune, it explodes. And the more people whistle, the bigger the explosion.
The next day, they go to the airport to get ready to go to Rio de Janeiro for the Olympics.
Then Sonic and Shonic bring up why they wasted $12 when they went to go see Fantastic Four.
Well, I know one thing. That god-awful Fantastic Four was garbage! That abomination.
Anyway, they arrive in Rio and Sonic decides to go take a little nap because he's jet-lagged.
And this is where I come in with the opening ceremony. They actually mentioned me in this little tiny bit.
But at the same time, poor Sonic collapses on stage after seeing Zaz and Zabik again.
The next day, Sonic wakes up and tries to go talk to Mario before the track event starts, and then comes Zaz and Zabik.
Then they bring up that poor video of Sonic puking that Eggman posted it. Seriously, how did they get a hold of that video?
Yeah, that video was disgusting, but thank goodness Sonic shot it out of their hands.
And after the first day of events at the Olympics, Sonic takes a shower and decides to go talk to Mario.
Sonic explains to Mario and Shonic that he has a plan to stop the Deadly Six, and that's the end of part one.
Part two starts out at the archery area of day two at the Olympics, with Styx and Amy.
Styx is worried about shooting someone out, and then Amy starts singing Titanium. And in comes Sonic.
I'm bulletproof, nothing to lose. Fire away, fire away. A rainbow shade and take your aim. Fire away, fire away. Shoot me down, but I won't fall. I'm Titanium. Shoot me down, but I won't fall. I'm Titanium.
Then after day two at the Olympics, Mario meets up with Sonic at the Christ the Redeemer statue.
Then Sonic shows up after 20 minutes later after his spa treatment, and they talk about the plan.
Then they decided to go spy on Zaz and Zavik through the rooftops, parkour style.
Then they find out that Mephiles the Dark is real, and Zazzazava captures all of them.
This part really gets me. Mephiles tortures Sonic with a poison dagger.
And this is where we find out about Mephiles' plan, why he wanted Sonic.
It turns out that Mephiles wanted Sonic's blood to revive the rest of the Deadly Six.
Meanwhile, Sonic tricks Zaz on solving the white side of the Rubik's Cube, and he and Mario escape.
I gotta say, there was one awesome badass way to escape.
You bet it was, little buddy. And then they reunite with Sonic. And then Sonic started reacting to the poison and ended up in the hospital.
After Sonic ended up in the hospital, Sonic told him that he couldn't compete in the Olympics for 2 days because there was poison in his lungs.
Then Mephiles revives Xena, Zor, and Master Zik of the Deadly Six, and that's the end of part two.
Actually, there's one little detail. Mephiles is planning on killing the people of Rio de Janeiro at the end of the Olympics.
Now, part three starts out with Sonic at the Olympics, and he tells Amy and Shadow what's going on.
Then Sonic and Mario decide to go see Sonic at the hospital, and it turns out he's not there anymore.
Then Sonic returns to the hotel and finds out that Sonic is back at the hotel, and it turns out the doctor has actually got all the rest of the poison out of him.
Then Sonic, Sonic, and Mario discuss a plan on how to stop Mephiles and the Deadly Six.
But later that night, Sonic ended up having a nightmare, and Sonic told him that everything will be okay. And also, Sonic decides to listen to his iPod to help him sleep.
While Sonic and Mario are competing in the Olympics, Sonic sneaks into Mephiles' lair and steals the Scepter of Darkness.
After Sonic escaped Mephiles' lair, he calls Sonic and tells him he got the Scepter of Darkness.
Despite leaving Mephiles' lair, which is the Scratch, Sonic continues to tell Mario and Sonic the plan.
Then Sonic takes Sonic to show him the Sonbots, and they go into a little brotherly moment.
That scene with Sonic and Sonic was really loving. And Sonic gives out a big speech, and that was the end of part three.
And part four starts out as a Sonic-Amy moment. The biggest kiss scene I've ever seen.
That scene was amazing. It reminds me of you and David, because right in between the releases of part three and part four, you two became a thing.
That's right, little buddy. So anyway, we're now at the closing ceremony of the Olympic Games. And Sonic interrupts by giving out a big speech.
Right before the battle begins, we see Sonic whistling Titanium, and they bring out a Lord of the Rings reference.
There's a lot of movie references in here, like Captain America the Winter Soldier and some other ones. There's another one coming up soon.
Then the battle begins with everybody fighting off the robots and the Zeddy.
Sonic hands Mario machine gun, and then comes Wario versus Zomo in a hot dog eating contest. That was the best scene ever.
I couldn't stop laughing at that scene. That was hilarious.
Then in comes Xena versus Amy. Xena starts off by making fun of Amy's outfit.
Then Sonic comes in and does a Kim Possible reference and asks Amy to beat up Xena while he sings Bang Bang Maxwell's Silver Hammer.
And here comes another Sonic-Amy kiss moment. And Mario says, no time for love.
Now it's time for another Zeddy to go bye-bye. This time, it's Sonic versus Master Zik.
After Sonic destroys Master Zik, it is now time for Shadow to go against Zavok.
While Sonic and Mario handle Zaz.
Then in comes Mephiles to persuade Sonic to join his side. But Sonic refuses and says that Mario is his best friend. Then in comes Six with her bow and arrow to shoot Mephiles down.
Then Mephiles makes Six mad with a really bad stick pun.
Then Amy comes in to save Six, and then all of a sudden Mephiles hits Amy to the ground.
Then made Sonic very furious, because nobody touches his girlfriend ever.
That would be David's reaction if anything happened to me. So anyway, everyone proceeds to attack Mephiles.
After taking down Zavok, the last of the Zeddy, Shadow rejoins the group and asks Sonic to give him the Scepter of Darkness.
Then Sonic solves all the sides of his Rubik's Cube, and everyone whistles the four-note Mockingjay tune, and that's the end of the battle.
The next morning, everyone is at the airport getting ready to go home. Oh, well, Sonic, Sonic, and Mario are not going home because they're going to Whistler to show Sonic.
Then we have one more little Sonic-Amy moment, and then Sonic, Sonic, and Mario go to Whistler, and that's where it ends.
This little series had it all. Action, romance, and comedy.
The comedy was hilarious. The battle was perfect. And even all of the Saw and Amy moment was awesome.
Let's not forget all those movie references. Those were actually very spot on.
And I'm so glad I met a guy like David McInerney that I know and love. So I'm going to give his series an over 9,000 out of 10.
I give it an over 9,000 out of 10 as well, Gene.
When I go watch Mario and Sonic Revenge of the Deadly Six again, little buddy?
Oh, fuck yes I do!